visible now. Yep. Let's back. I'm wearing the wrong shirt. My head's in the right place though. Move this canvas a little bit. Yeah, reckon I can finish this tonight. Oh, I shouldn't have said that out loud. It's foolish. Into charge as well.
Can we do to salvage this?
Yeah.
And like,
ooh, what was that? Ah. Something's still playing in the background. Right, that's better. Let's go. Someone's poked their head in on Facebook. See what's going on. What's going on is I've been doing this painting every night for 2 hours since Monday. And now I think it might be time to approach an end. Small brushes first. I'm going to need the red shirt of importance because that isn't finished yet. Thank you.
gold outfit on. And Twitch is on. Yeah, should be good to go then. Lots of stopping and starting tonight. Hi Matt. Dark. I don't know what yesterday's paint is going to react like. I know there's a darker shape under there. Is that too red? Maybe it should be bluer. I'll do a little bluer satellite of that. And here's where I can start to get into the deep shadows. Some there. I think I'm going to have to work into these with some of that light colour again. That's too much. Red is still wet from yesterday, so I can work into that, which is good. That's good news. A bit of heavy dark underneath it. To here. And in there, it's like a halfway dark colour, which kind of goes underneath that sleeve. Slightly bluer one. Let's see how that looks. Yeah. Yep, I like that. Where else does that go? It goes in here a bit. And into there a little bit as well. Where else? Here into the sleeve. Is that too much? No, I think I'll get away with that. I'm going to work some lights back over the top of this afterwards anyway. to get caught up with too much detail anyhow. Okay, where else is this going to go? Inside that collar there. Strong there, but that's okay, it's mixing in as it goes along. Between the two. Okay, that's enough fiddling with the shirt. Yes, Renata, si. Autorutrato, is that, did I say that right? Auto. Self-portrait. It is indeed. Right, I've got some bluey greys there. That's too weak. That's too thin. No, I'm going to have to mix thicker paint for that. Let's get this. That's the black I mixed earlier, just from primaries. I'm going to put some extra blue in there. That should do its job nicely. Let's put it over here. Okay, so there is a blacker black to come, but to begin with, it's another greeny one. We'll do sticking out. Some sock. Some seat. That edge. Yeah. Shouldn't go too far with it. This is a slightly blacker version of this red here, which is starting to go off. So I'll put a bit of oil in that. Keep it going a bit. Put the rest of that black in it. Job for the shape under the easel here. Yeah. Yes. Let's pick up the red. go in there. Some other bits of red which get a bit brighter as we come away, but I'm going to have to mix more paint for that. So I had this blue from yesterday, and that's starting to go off too. Amazing. Let's make the rest of that black with it. I'm not going to go too far with trying to make this perfect or anything. Shapes. Matches up. That's good. So all this bit here is all the blue. Let's have a bit more of that blue back. Definitely going to have to do some mixing here. I can't believe that's drying already after one day. There you go. So it's coming up. I bet that with that creamy yellow, tiny, tiny amount of it though. I'm gonna put these over here. This is all coming up. None of that's necessary. Turned into a big mess at some point. I'm going to have to reclaim it. Which means before I even start, I'm going to spend 10 minutes scraping the palette. Which I know isn't much entertainment, but hey, what were you expecting? The worst of the paint off the surface. fun, isn't it? Yeah, so it's amazing. We're getting quite close to Monday again already. So I don't know what I'm going to do for the live stream on Monday. Hopefully this will be finished. I say hopefully. I'm just trying not to fiddle with it too much. I do like having a nice clean palette, or a usable palette, it doesn't have to look clean. It just has to not have bits on it, because that annoys me. This is due a proper clean, this palette. The mixing space is gradually shrinking session by session. Considering this a kind of a final act with the live stream, I think the live stream is gradually coming to an end, at least in its present form. It's interesting, when I started, people didn't believe me, but I think I've really proved that nobody cares about painting. You know, they were saying, oh, if you keep doing it, it'll end up being really popular, and you'll have loads of people, you know, tuning in, and it'll catch on, and people, you know, tell each other. But no, none of that has happened. Exactly as I predicted. It's just been fairly anonymous and routinely ignored, which I like. Please don't feel like I'm complaining for a second. It's wonderful. It's reassuring. Brown. Always a fun colour to make brown. Before I do that, some more cad red and raw umber. It's just me and you, man. I put my new live stream on YouTube and it said, do you want to premiere it? And I thought, well, that sounds good. I wonder what that will do. So I premiered it and nobody has seen it. It's shown it to absolutely no one. Or anyone it has shown it to has expressed no interest whatsoever. It's great. Yeah, no views. But it was only premiered on February the 17th. I don't know what on earth that's meant to do, but there you are, that's that. I'll put my palette knife down somewhere. Well, it couldn't have gone far. What did I do with it? I found a tube of violet though. I might use that. There it is. Brown. Delicious brown. It's just us. Oh, hello, Catherine. Nice of you to pop in. I should be able to put some music on, but I think YouTube would come down on me like a ton of bricks. Probably Facebook would too. That's too light. Let's make a darker one just next to it. Too dark. Well, no, maybe that's about right. Probably needs to be oranger. Let's put some of that orange in. It's my first experience of gambling paints, and I wish I were more impressed. It's a bit. No, it seems like it's watered down. Spatula to put that on. I hope it works. Especially here, this is where I want an edge. I want to build that edge out of paint. Let me get some lighter. see if this works. Partly this is all about getting rid of that texture of the canvas there. That's part of it. But it's also replacing it with this sort of flat surface. So I've got this shadow that comes down the edge. That does stop there. That's good. This corner that sticks out. Carry that light across a little bit. That should do it while that's there. Sort of inside edge of a of that tape that goes around the edge of the palette. Okay. And hopefully I can recycle this as I go along, but first of all, I'm going to need a slightly lighter, slightly greyer version of that. Dry paint that forms an edge and it gets a bit greener and lighter. It's quite the voyage of discovery, this. Well, I promise it is a lot more exciting than it appears. At least it is to me. Okay, so that's that nice bluish edge. Would that have been darker? Probably, but it's not going to make a big difference. Right, so I've put some big splodges of this grey in, just check that looks pretty good. That needs a bit of orange in it too. This orange light gets everywhere. I'll put a few of these splodges on. Afterwards, I should be able to go over it with a spatula. And these will flatten out. It'll give me a bit of a change in the texture. It's done very little, but visually it looks okay.
Hmm.
Let's get some of that brown and make it darker. This is the shadow colour here. It's kind of really building a structure. That's too light. Somewhere in between the two. Okay, a slightly better version of this. This box that my palette goes on. An even darker version of this. This will give me the shadow. That will make that edge nice and crisp as well. In there too. This doesn't have to be super accurate because it's not detail. Anywhere else I can put this? I've got some lovely neutral colours to start off with. There's a nice contrast there with the texture of the paint. So it sits up off the carpet. The carpet's all done quite thinly, so. Right, let's not overdo that. A bit extra light just on the edge. Brush brushwork just to tighten up the edge there. Come on, in you go. Behave yourself. Good. Something between this grey and this yellow. Yeah, I've got that white colour. There. It's not quite in the right place. Yeah, as I move around slightly, it's going to change, but not too much. Even darker here. That's basically white, but it's this dark grey colour. Very funny how that works. The manner of mysteries. Right. Let's put some red in there. Very, very dark red. Just where the shadows go. All suitably dark. Just do a bit more of that blue as well. Just going to go in here. I'm being really rough with this now. Definitely going to go in there. It will lighten up on the other side. Slightly lighter version. Just go in here and here. A few other bits and pieces. Let's turn that colour up a little bit. A few little dabs of blue. That's fine. Fiddle any more than that. The edge of the carpet over there. A few few other shapes in here. It gets darker. So, like I said before, it gets more purple towards the edge of the room. Let's chuck some of that in there. A bit of carpet. It's getting closer and closer to the time where I can't ignore doing flesh tones. It's going to have to happen. Before I do that, let's make a light green. Let's put some of it out across this. Shall I do all my tubes of paint on the arm of the chair? I should. Maybe just a few of them. It's a rather half-baked effort at that green colour. Down into that browny colour. Little creases, it's the dark shapes that will really show them up. I'm glad you like the carpet, Josie. I think you're being too kind. I think if you get to see it in person, you'll realise just how little I've done. Okay. Right. That's the back of a paint tube. That's the shadow underneath at the front. I'm going for these purpley shadows because they contrast nicely with the green. A bit of that there, a bit of that there. Strike for that one at the back. And then on them. Should go there. That's in a few little highlights, I guess. Especially around that metal bit at the top. Let's put a few little purpley dabs just to go underneath those. And a few little bright highlights to go on the top. Borrow a bit of the orange. Let's see if this works. This brush is probably too big, but there we go.
Little highlight.
And I've got some of my little paint tubes. A bit of extra orange in there. A few last highlights just along the top. On the top edge of that one, and here, and here. Nice row of paint tubes, that's rather fun. While I've got that colour on the brush, I'm going to thicken up the light on the phone, especially here in this bottom corner, and just where the little charger sticks out. I'll make a slightly greyer one for the rest. Also some fun little things going on the inside, which are darker than that, which is me painting. Little lines of text underneath telling me what's going on. It's fun doing these little fine details. Shadow on that neck of that char. There's also this jar here. Jar. Oh, camera switch itself off. Slightly lighter yellowy bits in there as well. internally it's behaving itself. In there. Let's blue that down. See what we can get away with. Yeah, extra bit of bluey green at the bottom. That's my jar. Make a little bright version of that. At the bottom. I don't know if I'm happy with that. I suppose I haven't done the orange label yet. Bit of that gloom. Oh, I didn't put any more cad red out. Will that do it? A bit lighter even. Is there, let's make a shadowy version where it goes into the dark. Do the same thing with the yellow. Let's put a bit of dark yellow in there. Let's blotch the real thing. Same thing with the brushes. That orange is already pretty good. I'm going to start with a brownie colour. Again. Bit on the top of that one. A little flash of highlight just in the middle. Back to this, that's the brush I'm painting with. Oh, it's quite a lot of effort and concentration at this stage. But it's working.
Let's do a little close up of those details I just did. So I've got the tubes of paint on the arm of the chair, and what have you?
Yeah. Definitely need a little break now.
Yeah, I can see some things that need need to behave themselves a bit better. It's getting there though. A few more darks to go in. And then the last thing is to mess up the actual face. Yeah, it'd be fun to see how that comes out.
Yes, the mirror is a mind melter. You're quite right. But it's also a kind of a good key to letting go of what you think you see and concentrating on what you really do. So many lines go in different directions to what you think. Yes, I'm going to prop it there. I'm going to move these because they're not helping. I don't need to do loads of detail for the arm of the chair, but I do need to do some. Just to keep things even. This is great. I'm getting feedback from artists around the country. Stuff that they're not going to, probably not going to say on a, on, well, no, nothing very insulting or rude or anything, but yeah, these tubes, I need to create some spaces so that you can tell they're tubes. One there. These ones can move. I'll put that extra one at the back. And maybe I'll put this sideways on. No. Like that, pointing inwards. Okay, yeah, before I get stuck into the portrait bit, let's just get this, chair working properly. Ah, mess. Right, I had this green colour, that was the highlight on the arm colour. Does that still work? Yes, it does. So I'm going to want some more of that. Yes, there is on the front, but it's also darker. So I'll keep a bit of that for the highlight colour. It's also going to be a bit greyer. Mix a darker green there. Nice dark, dense green. And that can feed into other things. Right, this one at the front. So that might be too green, but let's something, and then there's an even bluer one. Into the purpley sort of colour. I appreciate feedback. Always useful. Sofa colours, let's get a few brushes ready. Two green. That'll just be for highlights then. Let's go into this. Do this and put some of these darks in next, and then work the highlights over the top. It's going to get darker. Get rid of that tube there, that's not necessary. And this one, that's not needed. Should be a bit more discernible as tubes of paint now, especially when I put that last one on. All green at the bottom. So that plays around. Super dark darks in next. I'll do this with the brush mix. Let's see how it behaves. It's basically just ultramarine, a bit of raw umber and a bit of red. Across. as well. Buttons. Okay. Now a few of those little highlights should do a big job. Need to be light paler even and probably bluer. He says putting some red in it. Okay, here we are. Just to be really cheeky, I'll invent a few colour bands for these, and I think red might be a good one to start with. So let's have a bit of that there. The top. If I do a blue one as well, then that should really drive the point home, shouldn't it? If I do that silvery tube in the background too. Let's put that in here. No, I need to actually mix thick paint to make that happen. Is this going to work? That's better. Chuck a few highlights on that afterwards. What was I going to do? Oh yeah, blue. Tubes. Yeah. As are. Yeah. Let's do a few of these deeper shadows just to go in here. So that's going to need a bit. It's going to need a bit in there. Cap. just a touch of light there. No, that's done almost nothing. Rick? No. Rick, yes. What about here? I overdid that. That's alright, I've still got my greens. There you are. That is now a paint tube, definitely. He says. Some more cadmium red out. Just while I've got that alizarin, I'll do the shadow version of that cadmium red, which is going to go in there. And the even shadowy version of that alizarin, which is going to go in here. Sure about this gambling stuff at all. Seems to have separated in the tube. There you are. Do for describing itself. I was using naphthol red actually. I'm going to stick with the naphthol. Well, thanks to everyone for coming along and saying nice things. I always appreciate that. That's the palette painted in now. Complete with a little highlight on the blue. Go back to this lovely shadow colour. Take your shadow under that. And actually coming together now. After a fashion. This is all balancing out. Before I clean up the palette at all, I quite like that little highlight colour there. Goes on that blind a bit. Down a little. A little reflection from the lamp. A few other things while I notice them. This needs to level out. Does good. More shadow under this cat. There's no way around it. I've got to actually paint my stupid face in it. It makes a kind of pasty pink colour. Thank you. Oh, that's way too yellow. Three brushes. I should be ready to start. Okay. Three small brushes, one's already got the dark warm on it. Start with that. Okay. Features where they are at the moment, because it seems to hint those eyebrows are higher. Shapes. Okay, that's some structure of kind. Let's go with these pale colours. That's way too pale at the moment, so I'll start at the top. Between that and the colourful one, I'll be able to start getting somewhere. Just for too thin, but there you go. It'll hold the place. Starting to appear. While I've got these simple colours on, I'm going to keep going and do actually the palette knife can go on the palette, because that's where I painted it. Shadows first and then pull the lights out afterwards. Just picked up some red off the shirt, but I'm not worrying about that. What about this? That's all going to be a lot greener, but there's a nice big shape in there. That's the end of my finger. Somewhere between there. I've lost track of what colour I was on, but let's keep going with that. That's all going to look a lot bluer. Shadow that goes on the underneath of the arm there. Okay, back to this. This is especially tricky at the moment because I'm painting with the same hand I'm doing a painting of. Okay. Go back to this one. Some more reds in there. Probably overdo it with the reds, but there we go. Grey version of that. Put it in here. Those lights in the shadows, and also in that finger there. Also a bit in there. Discoveries happening now. water, a bit lighter. That's quite a lot lighter. That's the shape of the thumb. Feel those lights in the fingers just where they stick out there and here. Not too much detail. And along the top of the hand. Okay, before I put the bright highlights in, I'm going to go in with some of the greens. Yes, there are greens. They're quite visible. There's a few. There's a few in the arm. Some on the thumb. Actually a few of those reflected lights there. There's some blues too, we'll come to those later. About here. No, see that's not dark enough. Let's do a blue version. There's there. Where was there on here? Under here. Should go right down into the arm there. Yes. The opposite and doing some warmer shadows under that finger there, inside here as well, or a bit of that orange. I was going to see it. Is that there? No. Yes. I'm not totally sure what I'm seeing anymore. Okay, while I've got these other colours on, put a bit of that there, a bit there, where is this? There is some orange. There's going to be some under the chin here, it's reflecting the shirt. Have a little break. Has everyone gone to bed? Oh, still somebody still with me. Nice to see you. noticing some subtle lights coming up here. Subtle ones. Tips of the fingers. So there. No, I'm not going to do fine details, not just yet. What about here? Too light, too soon. Gotta hold back a bit. There's a pinker car first. It's probably something more like this. Yeah. So it goes in there, and a little bit into the little finger. It's all green again. Just for the light, works quite well. Yeah, let's pop a bit in there. This all gets a bit blue under there. Still see the shapes. Okay, I think I've got one last brush I haven't sullied. Hang on. Is that green colour on there? Yeah, it was. Let's see if I can find some of that in my face. even more. Oh, and we're back to our green. Do a darker blue or green. Bit of that in there. We've got a bit of green underneath the arm. So yes, highlights time. Pop a tiny tab of orange in that bit. Okay. That is a highlight. Lighter for some of that as well. Nice little shine on the thumbnail. Okay, I'll put that highlight on. There's a bit there. The shine on that finger. The whole section of the thumb, which catches that light. Entirely happy with that hand yet. It needs a bit more pink. Let's see how brave we can make that pink. That's quite brave. Where else does it go? Inside of the thumb. Fingers, what about on my face? Nose. Lower lip. Cheek. Next to the eye. turn back into this highlight colour. I keep being urged to enter Sky Portrait Artist of the Year, so I might put this their way and look forward to adding to my collection of rejection letters. There. It's quite interesting how this stuff turns up. Yeah, that's starting to come together now. I'm going to give myself another break before I carry on. Maybe I'll finish this tomorrow night. Concerted effort this evening. We'll get it done. Oh, I forgot to look at Twitch. That's alright. No one's left a comment. That's okay. A bit of a clear up. Get along again. Doing okay. Need a bit more contrast in the chairs, or maybe a bit less in the bookcase. I can't decide.
mess figuring out what next. It's not much to finish this off. There are other things in the background and things that need a bit of fiddling with, but not too much. Things like the pictures on the walls. Did a little bit of touching up. Maybe the chair's okay. Maybe we just need to soften down the shadows in the bookcase a bit. Or leave the bookcase and deepen the shadows in the window and the pictures. Because now the heavy darks and things are in, like under the collar of the shirt. I can afford to strengthen what's behind a little bit. A bit of carpet adjusting to do as well. Not quite happy with that. Only a little bit. What does that matter? The shadows under the box aren't quite deep enough. Yeah. At this stage of a painting, you really have to take your time, figure out what's next. Quite pleased with getting a decent amount of paint on the surface. Yeah, I need to think about this a bit. And it's gone 11. To do a few more bits. I'm trying to establish the
missing bits of the face. And the sleeves and the shirt, I think I could probably establish them as well. First things first. Let's give me a top lip. Kind of an image turning up, which is vaguely recognisable to me as my face. Okay, let's go back into some of these slightly lighter colours. Feels like I'm picking up paint, but not doing anything. Well, that's probably a sign. going. Okay. A few highlights. I was actually going to save these for the what would you call it? The flake white. Starting to happen now. To feel like I'm looking at me. Yeah, there he is. Bugger, isn't he? Okay. That's someone texting me telling me to leave it alone. Oh, I'm there though. Oh, I can't even find it. Me look at them again. I would have come back to them anyway. Just like there's lots of things I'm going to repaint, like the tissues in the box aren't quite right, and there isn't enough contrast in these pictures compared to that bookcase. There's lots of little things, but it's little tweaky stuff. And also, I hadn't got around to actually painting the sofa itself, so you can see that now, and it sits behind by roughly the right amount, so I know I'm quite happy with that. I appreciate it. looking. You guys are trying to land the mouth. Let's keep it vague until I'm sure that shadow can go in the middle, these lights can go on either side. Good. Get a red in this green, and I'll have a colour for my shirt as well. Okay, that's too much red. A bit of blue back in it. That's too much blue. Decent sized brush. This is closer to the lighter colour than it is to the black. Put a bit more of this in. To lighten much. And then let's put some of these darks in, especially in there. Yeah, a bit, big contrast there. Same kind of thing with the jeans. That's a bit bluer. How neutral is that? Not very, a bit too blue. A lot more like it. relaxing afterwards. This one of those creases. Shadow underneath the hand, why not? Put an extra shadow behind the leg into that redder colour. Yeah, I said I was going to move this, didn't I? And I am. Brush handy. We're wearing this sort of colour, aren't we? Actually, a bit light if anything, but oh, yeah, more like this one. Sure what's going on under there, but that's fine. Okay, while I've got that light on, let's put a bit of light on here. On here. On here. That's the subtle. On there. Blue. Let's pick up an extra bit of light. Give that its little halo at the edge. So it's still going to have this bit of shadow in the sleeve there. This one's still going to have this bit of shadow in the sleeve there. And there. In fact, I know I'm going to move that even further forwards. Shadow under the hair here. Yeah. Okay. Right, where was I? Seems pretty close to it. It'll do. About over here. Yeah. The same as. have a couple of little buttons. They do have little buttons. A nice little detail. Okay, this is pretty close now. Aspects I'm generally holding. These brushes. And a tissue. Something like that. Right, nice rosy orange colour up front. Enough. That's more naphtha red. There we go. This little flash of yellowy light across it. Surface a bit as it goes down the ferrule, and there on the end of the brush I think I'll put a blob of red. Okay. Last thing, a bit more dark around that hand I think. That's a good sign, that means I'm nearly done. Bit of extra dark in there. And extra dark reds. Bottom of that sleeve just hanging down, playing around. Cuff. Yes. Right, so I haven't finished the face. There's more contrast to go in. But other than that, it's pretty close. I thought it was a bit ambitious to try and finish it tonight, but there you go. Oh, thank you, Jason. And if Josie's still there, thanks for sticking with it. All right. Streamlabs so I can see what's going on. Let's just move the whole thing. Bit too much contrast in the shirt there, but the face has to catch up. Once I've got that extra contrast in the face, it should behave itself. I've got my palette. I haven't done the orange toe on my sock yet. There's other little bits of colour to bring up, but overall. Oh, and once the picture's done, I have to do the picture in the canvas as it's reflected on the easel, which at the moment you can see is empty. Yeah. There. So, I guess join me tomorrow. Well, I may or may not finish this picture. Who knows? That needs to go further back. Maybe we'll try and get it in the right place. Yeah, so I might finish this tomorrow. We'll see. Ah. Oh, thanks, Tom. Yeah, I'm not going to fiddle with it anymore tonight. I think doing this in little 2-hour chunks has been quite good. I think it's made me approach it rather differently. I haven't rushed to finish it, giving myself a bit more time. See, the self-portrait bit needs a bit more work. There's a few little details here and there that I want to fiddle with. But the bendy mirror is working quite well. Yeah, I'm generally okay with this at the moment. So that's always a good sign. I'm not throwing things, put it that way. Yeah. So yeah, see you tomorrow. Thanks for joining me. That's been lovely. Thanks, Matt.